Close your eyes and imagine. Are you doing it? Go ahead. Come on. Don't be shy. Close your eyes. Imagine you're a kid. Imagine turning on the TV, flipping through the channels with one thing in mind. You're gonna watch baseball. You're so excited to watch this game, and you see the players on your screen, and you tell yourself, I'm gonna be just like them one day. Maybe this scenario doesn't apply to you particularly, but it definitely does to this guy, MLB outfielder Ryan Cort. My name is Gavin Norley, and I like to tell stories. Today, I'm gonna tell you the story of Ryan Cort. Ryan Cort was born May 28, 1988. He's an Illinois native, growing up in Elgin, Illinois. Wrigley Field is only 43 minutes away from Elgin, or 1 hour and 1 minute if you avoid tolls. So Cort's dad would take him to Cubs games 5 to 6 times a year. Cort grew up loving the Cubs, and I can't say for sure these moments with his dad watching the Cubs is what gave him the drive to be an MLB player, but I like to think it is. In high school, Cort was a monster. In his senior year, he had a batting average of .406. Cort was a stud. After playing high school ball at Dundee Ground, he went to Illinois State to play college baseball. His father was a football and tennis player at Illinois State. Again, not saying that's why he went here, but I like to think that's why. I think what he did in college speaks a lot to Cort's work ethic, and it's another reason why I like him. In his last 3 years at Illinois State, he never missed a start. He worked day in and day out for his college team and hit .323 in college. After college at age 23, Ryan Cort was drafted by the Arizona Diamondbacks in the 23rd round of the MLB draft. According to Bleacher Report, the chances of a player drafted after the 21st round reaching the major leagues is a slim 7%. A 7% chance. There's no doubt in my mind Ryan Cort knew this would be a difficult journey, but he didn't quit. Cort played in the Diamondbacks minor league system for 3 years, playing for some awesomely named teams including the Silverhawks, Rawhide, and Bay Bears. However, the Diamondbacks released him on March 30th, 2015. For the remainder of 2015, Cort played for an independent baseball team. I can't imagine what it's like mentally, to work so hard for something for 4 years of your life and then have it taken from you. Cort spent 4 years with an organization just to be released without ever playing at the major league level once. I know he probably wasn't too hurt about being able to still play baseball after that, but I just can't imagine it being all sunshine and rainbows for him during this time. In 2016, Cort signed a major league deal with the Red Sox, played there for a year, and then signed with a team he was all too familiar with, the Chicago Cubs. Cort played in the minor leagues of the Cubs organization for 2 years. It must have been a dream come true for him just to say he's been a Chicago Cub, but he still never got to taste major league baseball. The Cubs released him after 2 years of service. Cort once again settled with independent baseball. You remember how earlier I said that I thought Ryan Cort was destroyed having to settle with independent baseball and not being able to play in the majors after all this time? Well, I know for a fact after this, he was, because he said it himself.
You go to indie ball your first time and you're like, ugh, should I keep playing? I had just got released and I was 27 in AA. It's like, will I ever get a chance? Then you go back and you have some success, then you get released again and people are like, keep doing it. It's your dream.
I believe Cort must have thought he was done. He's back where he was in 2015. He worked another 4 years just to still not reach the majors. He probably thought it was over. Ryan Cort was signed by the Mariners, and he played in their AAA system, one step away from the majors. Let's talk about the Seattle Mariners in 2019. 2018, they were red hot for the first half of the season. It seemed like they'd finally end the postseason drought they've been in since 2001. Alas, in true Mariners fashion, they didn't, and ended up placing third in their division and missing the playoffs. After this season, the M's decided to tear it down. Tear it all down. They traded so many pieces of their team in one offseason. In just that one offseason, they made 8 trades, all for young talent to build around in the future. The Mariners' plans for the 2019 season was to be bad, get high draft picks, and develop young talent in their system. the Mariners had a lot of players play for them in the 2019 season. In fact, they had the most any team has ever had. At the end of the season, they had 65 players used, setting the record for most players used in one season. 21 of those 65 players played their first MLB games ever, and one of those guys was Ryan Cort. In 2019, 261 players made their MLB debuts. There was a lot of new young talent debuting that season. 19-year-olds, 20 to 25-year-olds, and atop the list, at 31 years old, is Ryan Cort. He was the oldest player to make their MLB debut that season. An article in the Seattle Times was written about the call-up of Ryan Cort. It says, Ryan Cort pulled up to the parking garage at T-Mobile Park on Friday afternoon. His life forever changed. He hadn't slept the night before. How could he? And finally, the enormity of the situation hit him. An impossible dream was achieved. Exhausted and excited, he broke down into tears. This article shows Cort's personal side more than any other article that mentions him. The first thing he did was call his parents and girlfriend with the unbelievable news. They made immediate plans to be in Seattle for his big night. That's when all this sunk in and became real. Ryan Cort was not a starter in the first game he was in the majors for, but he played, and he was brought in. And the situation he was in was as high stakes as it could ever be, a tie ball game at the bottom of the ninth inning. Cort was brought in as a pinch hitter. I apologize for the quality of this video, but just listen to how excited Mariners broadcaster Dave Sims gets when Ryan Cort hits this ball. I found a video from someone in the crowd when this happened, and just listen to this crowd.
This is debut.
Who's gonna swing?
This debut.
For 1.9 seconds, Ryan Cort was a hero.
Let's go!
After this game, Cort eventually got hits under his belt and ended his time with the Mariners with a 208 batting average. Not amazing by itself, but for Ryan Cort, I can only imagine it's the greatest honor he's had. Ryan Cort made a post on his Instagram after his MLB debut, and his words are what made me want to make this video. Now, I won't quote his whole post, but I will quote one part. He said that, "I hope my journey will inspire others. Those of you who have hit a bump in the road, or many bumps, or are feeling stuck in whatever situation you're in, flip your perception of the circumstance. Let these challenges make you fearless in accomplishing whatever goals that keep you up at night. If you have any bit of fight left in you, that means you're still alive." Ryan Cort, when I first saw him play, was just a cool story. I knew he was 31, and I knew he was a rookie. That was it. Now it's been over a year, and he's not even a Mariner anymore, but the story is so beautiful and so human. I feel as though the most beautiful thing about sports is the stories of people that are like us. Ryan Cort, at one point, was a kid with a mom and a dad, and all he wanted was to play baseball. And Ryan Cort, at one point, has been at a point in our life where we have all been. He thought he had failed, like he wouldn't make his goals and dreams come true. But he didn't quit. He knew there had to be an up to the tremendous amount of downs he faced. I resonate with Ryan when it comes to that. I've seen a lot of downs in my life. I felt as though I've been a failure to my family many times. But I know my journey isn't over, and I know that my life is uphill from where I'm at. And I know that I have great things in my life, and I know that they're amazing because of the downs I have. Because when you have downs, ups feel even better. Ryan Cort and I know what down times in our lives feel like, but man, those downs make the ups feel way better. And I know Ryan knows that. I know he does.
Out to right field, blasted back by the wall.